serving my apprenticeship, he was a chap, an instructor, and he always used to say, oh, you're going to come in. Probably because I wasn't doing things quite like what he ought to. I ought to have been doing to it, in his opinion. And it's called, this poem is called Impervious Comedy. Breaking one's own mirror of embarrassment, so avoiding dropping into the darkness of a mental cellar, or whilst being prompted from behind consistently, he's going to grab you. Watch those clutching hands. Thus stimulating, a vision of hands appear from the sweating walls, a twisting movement of intimidation, now victimized in dungeons of lost horizon. Therefore, to live your life, a clown in realism, a neurotic to sympathizers, alas, unconscious zombies of society, they declare their verdict, you, the complete idiot. What forms such real result as this? An effusion of satire, that with incongruous result adds fanfare simulating a drunk who comforts his deepest doldrums of depression so communication can hide his inner unease. This is a bit more simple, really. It's the philosophy of watching kids playing on the at the seaside with the sandcastles. And it's called Creative Destruction. Town of sand, castle, indomitable keep, surrounded by frothy moat, proud edifice, partially destructive, by primitive impulse, childhood friends. Patience rebuilt to former glory, again suspect to barbaric aggression, junior minds, contagious desire, destruction. Creator assisting former adversaries, harmonizing with strong emotional current of feeling erased. Unnoticeable mound, scars washed clean, possessive scene, soothing waves, caress round on incoming tide.
I'm going to need to rehydrate because my brain is going out of the folks, that's fantastic. We're coming round at half time to see if the people still want to read two in the second half. You've got a choice, you don't have to. But if it's as good as the first half, it'll be fantastic. We're going to have a 10-minute break, get some cake, drinks and stuff. See you in 10 minutes.